So, you know when you're watching a film or television show, and there's a movie in that film or television show, and those scenes from those movies within those films and television shows never feel quite real, because characters are just speaking in stunted exposition, posing like action figures, and inevitably waiting for the reveal of some celebrity's face as a dramatic payoff. Yeah, Fast X is a lot like that. The 10th film in the inconsistently named Fast and Furious franchise opens with an extended flashback to the climactic action sequence of Fast 5. The Fast and the Furious. Too Fast, Too Furious. Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift. The movie from over a decade ago that reinvigorated the series by delivering a dose of franchise Viagra that went by the name of Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Yeah, they just slathered that rock hard Johnson in baby oil and jammed him right on in there.
Hey, Mia, you better hide your baby oil.
You better hide that big ass forehead.
I was just joking.
Fast 5 remains the best film in the series, and Fast X leans into this by replaying that powerhouse final action sequence, which remains one of the best things that Justin Lin ever directed. Fast X ostensibly replays that scene to reveal its villain origin story. In a film franchise where cars can leap between buildings and journey to outer space, Fast X makes perhaps the series' most implausible argument to date, that Jason Momoa was in the background of the climax of Fast 5, and you just didn't notice him. Now, the son of the bad guy whose name you can't remember from Fast 5 is back, and he wants revenge. Naturally, Fast X is a movie that's all about
family.
It's also about, and I really wish I were making this up, how the end of the road begins. However, cutting back to the climax of Fast 5 ultimately does Fast X few favors. It reminds the audience how good Justin Lin was at the action direction within the franchise, his skill with cutting the sequence together, and his understanding of the tension of playing with the laws of physics. Mass and gravity, action and reaction, even cartoon physics have some internal logic to them. The first big action sequence in Fast X is explicitly positioned by one of the characters as a roided up riff on that bank vault heist, with an homage to The Dark Knight Rises thrown in for good measure. It's enjoyable enough on its own terms, it's maybe the best sequence in the film, but the comparisons don't flatter new director Louis Leterrier, who seems to have been hired as much for his skill balancing movie star egos and studio notes on The Incredible Hulk as for his disjointed action editing. As the Fast and Furious franchise has developed, it has grown and expanded to an unwieldy degree. Fast X features returning cast members Vin Diesel, Michelle Rodriguez, Tyrese Gibson, Chris Ludacris Bridges, John Cena, Jordana Brewster, Natalie Emmanuel, Kang, Helen Mirren, Charlize Theron, Joaquin Del Almeida, and at least two more that would be considered spoilers in this review. It also has to make room for new arrivals Jason Momoa, Brie Larson, Alan Ritchson, Rita Moreno, and Daniela Melchior, many of whom are playing roles tied to pre-existing characters and lore. That's an incredibly large cast, and Fast X has to make sure that everyone gets something to do. The Fast and Furious franchise has always been something of a super-powered soap opera on steroids, both in front of and behind the camera. In part due to Leterrier's frantic ending style, and also down to the disjointed nature of the script, it's interesting to wonder which actors were and weren't on set with one another, and why. So much of the Fast and Furious saga plays out in the psychodrama of celebrity social media posts and star personas that what's happening on screen is frequently incoherent without that background context. To be fair, Fast X isn't a bad movie in the conventional sense. It's five extremely uneven movies clumsily stitched together, ending in a soap opera cliffhanger. Some of those movies are enjoyable on their own terms. Momoa is having the time of his life, pitching a campy performance that is perfectly in tune with the movie around him. There's a subplot involving John Cena as a super spy babysitter that is more charming than it has any right to be. But frustratingly, much of Fast X is just characters posing, revealing the next returning guest star, and muttering something incoherent about family. Sadly, Fast X goes nowhere fast. Fast X is releasing exclusively in theaters on Friday, May 19th.